Theo, I'd love to come out to Blanche to Thea. I can't tonight though, unfortunately. That's really shit. And thank you so much for asking or telling me it was on or whatever. I'd love to see you. Oh, I hope it all goes really well. It's gonna be amazing because you're amazing. And can't wait to see you next week. Okay, bye, love.
Is what I'm doing now basically is I'm making me living space. I'm also combining cobblestone because I'm going to use cobblestone for my stone tools because they're much stronger. I'm making me place. It's already dark. I like small places really, actually. Do I have more wood? Need more wood. I can build a door. I can lock myself in quickly if I want to. It's the first night. I like to feel safe. Have I gone too far? I think I've gone too far. I need to go back. This is the wrong place. Oh, it's getting light again. Phew, I've survived the first night. I don't install new games because I know what would happen to me. My character would die. Have you heard about Minecraft? A computer game?
Yeah.
It's very good. It's basically a survival thing. Puts you in the middle of nowhere, anywhere the game decides, and you have to pull it together. So you punch a tree and that tree gives you a block representing wood, and then from that wood you can have planks and sticks, and then when you have planks and sticks you can make a pickaxe or a sword, and then you can make your first stone tools, and then you can just mine stuff and you grow stuff, you kill animals, sorry Caroline, you make stuff from skins. You cook the meat in a furnace, and yeah, it's just brilliant. There's loads of stuff, you know. I have this world in Minecraft, but we have Minecraft, and I have a system when I'm building. I like to make a room 7x7 blocks. I like, for instance, I made a castle. It has two massive staircases. One of them is finished. It goes all the way from the seashore right up to the sky and back down to the bedrock. And it's where the mines are. You know, the mines are massive. There's massive mines. Like, it's Xbox, so it's limited by 800 blocks, the mines, you know. So you can just go in there and get lost and keep on walking. Like, imagine a world, a PC world, where you can just, like, not PC world, the shop, but, like, a PC world where you can just keep walking. And no one will ever be the wiser. Now, I have dug down into the rocks and found myself suddenly in a mine. And then I'm falling through the ceiling and into lava. You don't want that. So, I mean, I like to put a crafting table and a furnace into a room. There's space between them for an anvil. I like to enchant the anvil, you know, because, like, you can just add things together, like the word sharpness, for instance, like words, or fortune for your pickaxe. Like, because if you put fortune with a pickaxe, then you'll be able to pick up all the pieces of coal when you're mining, and this is vital for when you're mining diamonds. Did you see what happened there? Did everybody know it? It happened very quickly. You may have missed it. Some hearts came out of the horses there. That's lovely. That means I've tamed him. No, it's over now. You missed it. Sorry. So that horse, I can ride him, but he doesn't have a saddle. So that means he's going to do whatever he wants. I might be able to get a saddle later on if I go into the village. I can't just buy it. You have to barter it with a few diamonds off a friendly tradesperson. But the thing you need to know is, if you're playing your first game, sure, get a bit of dirt, build a house, get 3 sheep, make a bed. But there are skeletons, monsters, zombies, ghosts everywhere, creeping, always silently. And you'll be there in your bed, and they'll just creep up behind you, and all you'll hear is nothing, because they will kill you stone dead. They will kill you in the bed you sleep on. Like, it did get crazy for me for a little while in the beginning, mostly because I didn't know what to do, and I just kept digging myself into the ground, and all these monsters just kept killing me, but not anymore. I know what to do. You get a furnace, you make sticks and coal, and you put torches up everywhere, because creatures cannot spawn where the light is. Thank you. Thank you very much. You know, there's a tutorial for you. It's catchy because it's all natural and everything. There's a great following for Minecraft. People change the lyrics of popular songs and everything about Minecraft. Like, sometimes, let's be honest, I couldn't be arsed growing up because I just don't want to do anything, you know? Like, but then I kick myself and it's just fucking brilliant, you know? Like, I have this with everything, just not being bothered, but it does be great. I love the garden now as well. I have to finish that. I have to do the other half of the greenhouse because there's the peppers have flowers on them already, you know. I'm 38. I thought I was younger, I know. But it's easy to know my age at any time because you take whatever year it is now, it's 2018. So you take 20 and 18 and you add them together, it's 38. It takes a while before it comes, and then you'd want it to stop, but it won't. I don't know if it's from that or in general, but you see, I got panic attacks from that. But it was maybe too much coffee, too much of that, not enough of this, not enough sleep, not proper eating habits, everything together, and then it's just, you know, you wake up and you're anxious and you're checking these things online about what the Illuminati are doing to the world and you can't do anything about it and it all just goes to fucking shit, you know? But it's not so much of a problem now. I'm kind of putting myself into moderation, but you know, even now when I'm smoking it, I think they're going to come. The panic attacks, it's horrible, like, you know, because even though I'm having the thought, I think my heart is going to stop. Like, my heart is stopping, actually, but it's stupid because I'm putting my hand here and I can feel my heart ticking normally. And I ended up in hospital as well. And it was like everything was fine. It was okay. Because it's just in the fucking head. It's just in the fucking head. I'm fine now. I drink lots of water. Would you like some of my water? I can give you some water. We can leave it until later. It's tap water, but I have a filter. Two massive charcoal filters. It's a Berkey from the USA. And I have little pellets on top of the filters. It filters out the fluoride because fluoride is a poison. And I use toothpaste that has no fluoride in it as well, which is twice as expensive. But fuck the fluoride. It's calcifying your fucking pineal gland. Where is my coffee? It's the one without caffeine. Will we smoke this now? No. Is that a bit strong? These are tomatoes, these are peppers, these are ready, these are nearly ready. You can see the flowers. It's amazing when you just put a bit of tender love and care into something, the feedback you get from plants, the satisfaction. I like mushrooms as well. I'm going to grow mushrooms eventually. I haven't done any hallucinogens yet. Caroline, here? Do you think ayahuasca is too much of a shortcut, Orla? Because I know this woman and her husband did it, and he was grand for about a month and then he just went back to normal, to being a prick. But Sadhguru says that THC is putting a barrier between you and your body. Ammo, do you think that's true? You know nothing. You know nothing. You knew loads last night. Well, I think everything in moderation is key. Isn't that right, Emer? The epitome of moderation. So, it's what I'm trying to do with weed, actually. You know, because I have a special jumper. I call it my homeless jumper because I don't wash it. Look, if that's controversial for anyone, I'm sorry, but I don't wash it. And I have a special pocket, which is for weed. And I have that jumper with me in work or at home. And I'm managing not to have it all the time. And maybe, yes, I'm smoking more cigarettes as a result. But, you know, Rome wasn't built in a day, was it, Paddy? It's good to take one day at a time. Baby steps. I tried some quitting smokes as well. Veronica, you've done a great job at quitting smokes. It's very hard though because I couldn't think. I couldn't find any solutions. It's desperate, like. But I have leeks as well. You just cut them in half and they grow back. It's very good. The neighbor gave us a bike and that's got a thing on it that's supposed to like trigger a sensor for the brake lights, but it doesn't work anymore. Never worked actually. So when my wife was little, her mother was in a cult and she took her along one Sunday and my wife saw her mother get possessed by a demon and wriggle around on the floor like a little snake on the floor. It was horrible. She doesn't forget it. She was 7. Like a snake on the floor, the devil in her mom's face. But when she was older, she got her revenge and took her parents along to see the Christians. We don't go anywhere now though, none of us really. My wife is from Brazil, I'm from the Czech Republic, and we both came to Ireland. Then we went to live in the Czech Republic and then over to Brazil and back to Ireland. So Ireland, Czech Republic, Brazil, Ireland, and full circle. We went to the Czech Republic and we were living far from Prague and we went out for food. We were living far from family and we went to this restaurant. And we got into the restaurant, and everyone in the restaurant just went like this. And everyone who didn't do that, everyone went like this to them. And so we kind of had enough of that and we just came to Ireland. And it's not so bad in Ireland. Like, it wouldn't be that racist a country. It's good feedback for you, everyone. And I got a job here. Before I secured a job working as a door-to-door salesman for the Irish Cancer Society, I was first appointed a manager of a garage. Now, I had to go through these things. Like, I think everyone should go through these things because then you'd know what pressure everyone in garages is under. Like, I worked in Topaz and you have to deal with customers, you have to check the pumps, you have to open the boots, you have to see it's safe to open the boots, you have to check this fella rubbing the wine there, and this and that, and it's a completely different environment. And then there's a gang of youths come in, and they just grab everything off the shelf, and they do a legger, and it's absolutely mad, and it's actually fun at the same time. But before all that, I was in Brazil, and this is actually where I learned how to be a door-to-door seller. Like, I know, naturally, I'm a salesperson, and it's because, well, after half a year, I learned the language, Portuguese, and thanks to her parents just waffling on, I eventually picked it up, and I grabbed one of them off the wall, and I went out, and I was like, yes sir, no sir, 3 bags full sir, I can do this for you, I can do that for you, I can do a logo for you. And they lapped it up, they loved me because I was a foreigner and because I spoke their native tongue, you know, because I was able to make a shortcut, because English and Portuguese, in Portuguese you have difícil, which in English is difficult, and because the Czech grammar is very similar to Portuguese, I was able to combine these two things together, you know. Plus, of course, our parents, for half a year, they were just talking, and I understood nothing, until I learned, like a small baby. They just kept talking until I learned, until eventually we came home to Ireland, where I did a bit of door-to-door selling here. I couldn't get into it in the Czech Republic. I didn't want to do it. In Brazil, I just kept going. But here, I was working for Vodafone. And, you know, their sales pitch was like, don't let the customers think. Don't let the customers talk. And I just felt like I was playing bullshit to them, you know? So, and I think, you know, saying it to you now, it's what happened to me just last week with the guy from Airtricity. He rang me and he was like, oh, your neighbor has Airtricity. And that's how he got me, because I'm friends with the neighbor, actually, kind of. And he hooked me. I've been fucking mind controlled, bastard. I mean, I know lots about lots of different things, but not into much detail, you know? When I don't know about something, I like to take it and put it on the shelf for later. And then when I come back to it with this idea or that, and put the two together, it always makes sense, you know? That's what it is to be open-minded. Like that. It's a nightlight. Or B3. Changes colour. We do them custom, actually. We had massive sales about 2 years ago to the States for the Ghostbusters. I think about 15 Ghostbusters went over altogether. 30 nightlights to the States altogether. Yeah. €80 plus postage for the Ghostbusters. Or B3, 3mm paper, save for kids and all that. I had 3 wishes in life. One was to have a wife just like Rosie, and I have that now. The second wish was to have 2 healthy boys. And the third wish was to know the truth. Said, who the hell is that? I mean, I still sleep on the couch, which is nowhere better to sleep. But I used to have a short fuse, especially with the kids. And now people say that I have even more patience than her. Like people, her workmates and all used to say her blood pressure was low because of her patience level. Well, if you think you're patient, God's going to send you, me, to test you. I think God was the only one who knew that the only person going to be long enough with me was her. Starseed.
Bring him home.